Hello friends, welcome to English classes with Atadipa. We were dealing with writing skills for class 12 CBSE. So last, in the previous lecture, lecture 1, we had done notice writing. And today in lecture 2 series, we are doing poster making. So let's begin. A poster making is used to spread awareness regarding a social issue, an event or a product. So what is exactly a poster? Poster is a type of content which is including a picture in it and also includes a lot of content which is spreading awareness on social issues or an event or any product. So it is talking about many things in one particular poster. So now we have to discuss here what is the format of a poster. This is the 100 million question, because most of the students, they are lagging behind because they do not know what is the correct format of a poster. So please focus here. The important points to remember while designing a poster that we should keep in mind. So what is that? First of all, while making a poster, you have to give a heading. Heading is the very essential part of the poster. Without heading, no poster is complete. So you have to give a heading to it. Write a catchy line or slogan. So once you have given a heading, after that you have to write a slogan. Slogan that can be made by using jargons or metaphors. So you can write one small catchy line which attracts the people who are seeing your poster. Then the third point is, remember to illustrate your poster with a sketch, that is to put a picture. So when you are making a poster, your poster is incomplete if you are not using a picture, because that picture also contains marks. There is no fixed layout. So there is no fixed layout because poster can be in any way. So you can design your poster in your way. Like you can place a picture somewhere in any corner of the box. So that is up to you. So whichever way you like, you can create a poster. But remember, it should be in a box. Use convincing language. So your language when you are making a poster, your language should be convincing. It should be accurate. It should not have any fault. And it should be short and concise. So these are few points that you need to remember when you are designing a poster. And also remember that you have to follow word limit, that is 50 words. So there are different topics on which you are asked to make a poster in board exam. So let's say it may be related to social issues like global warming, water scarcity, or sanitation and hygiene, or environment. So there can be any topic that is related to social issues, environmental issues, and political issues as well. And there are other types of topics that can be dealt with that are like event organization. So let's say you are organizing any blood camp. So that blood camp is an event. So for that, you are using a poster. On that poster, you can create a picture when people are donating blood. There is a queue. And then why blood donation is important, and then how it is making difference in the lives of people. So you can create all these points. You can note all these points in the poster and then mention them with the picture. So these are here we have a few points which should be remembered while dealing with the topics like awareness, which are awareness related issues. Okay, so let's see. Mention the following points here, like heading. As I told you earlier, the heading is the essential part of it. Then you have to address the problems and its causes. So what is the problem? What is the social issue that you have to talk about? And then what are the causes? So what is the thing that is increasing, that issue? What is the thing that is giving or aggravating that issue? So that you have to address in short. And then you have to talk about effect of problem. So let's say if there is a water scarcity, then you have to tell first that what is water scarcity, what can happen due to water scarcity, and then what are the effects of water scarcity. And later on, you have to also suggest the solutions. Without solution, your poster is incomplete. So first of all, you have to address a problem, then you have to talk about the causes which are increasing it, then what are the effects of problem, then solution, provide a solution how you can solve this problem as per your way. And add any additional information that you feel like it should be invented or that should be supported in your arguments. So you can add that information here. And at the end, name the issuing authority. So when you are writing a poster, the poster is actually made in the interest of people. So when it is done in the interest of people, so there must be some issuing authority. So that issuing authority name should be addressed at the end. If it is not given in a question, you have to create an issuing authority at your own will. But please be sensible here. And then at the end, you have to create a box. So whatever content you are making, whatever picture, content and problem solution, everything that you are providing here, that should be completely closed in a box. Further, as I told you earlier that in notice making, poster making and advertisement, they all come in a 4-marker question. So this is again a 4-marker question here in poster making, and then see how 4 marks are divided. So first is format. Format is given for 1 mark, you are given for format. Second is content. So when you are making a content, your content should be accurate, it should be lucid, it should be clear, it should be convincing, it should be, it should contain all the valuable points which are necessary to be implemented in that. So content is given 2 marks. Then you have expression. Expression requires your accuracy, how good, how you have used the words. So your words usage should be effective in nature. So that is coming in expressions. That is given 1 mark. Right. So your box and your heading, the way you have created a picture, I mean the picture placement, box and heading, all these things are noted in format. And content, the whatever content you are writing, problem, causes, effects and solution, everything is given in the content. And also issuing authority is also included in the format only. Then expression, the way you have created your content, that included in expression. Okay, so next, okay, one more important thing that I would suggest here, this is from my call, that is remember 5 C's. 5 C's, what I call 5 C's are, 5 C's are very important in any composition that you are doing, whether it is short, long or any sort of composition, any sort of answer that you are writing. So these 5 C's you have to keep in mind. What are these? First of all, clarity. So whatever you are writing, that should be clear in nature. It should be lucid. It should not be ambiguous, because ambiguity, once your ambiguity comes in your writing or in any answer, then it becomes very messy and it becomes difficult for the teacher also to understand what do you want to convey. So that ambiguity should be avoided. Second is completeness. So whatever idea you want to convey, that should be complete. It should not be left in between, or you should not understand this way or that whatever you have said it completely. No, it is also dependent on the other person who is going to read it. He should also feel that whatever you have written, that is complete in nature. So idea should be conveyed completely. Then conciseness. Conciseness means compactness. You should write it in a compact way. I mean, it should not be very lengthy. It should not be, so elaborated that when the person is reading and while reading, the person will get bored. It should not be like that. It should be concise and very clear. Third is correctness. So the kind of language you are using, that should be correct. There should not be faulty language. You should not use any sort of language which is not creating proper meaning, which is ambiguous or vague. Third is coherence. Your idea should match. So the first idea that you have given and the third idea you are giving, they should combine. I mean, they should be in relation to each other. It should not be so abrupt, right? The first idea you've given and second idea is not matching to the first idea. So your idea should go alongside. So they should match. This is what we call coherence. Coherence is the matching of the ideas. Now here is a sample of poster for you that I've made. So the question I've written here, that water is precious and each one of us must stop wastage. So prepare a poster on that. So I've not written here the other part of the question, that prepare a poster in 50 words and invent all the necessary details. Okay. So I'm writing the poster right away here. So what I have done, I have put a heading here. Water is the essence of life. So as you can see through the heading that it is about water. Okay. So water is the essence of life. Then I have put a picture also, that what I'm going to talk about is save water. See. So what was the question? What is precious and we must stop wastage. So we are dealing with that only, save water. Now issue, what is the issue here? As I told you earlier, that first of all, you have to address the problem. So what is the problem? Rapid decrease in water table. So water table is decreasing, and once the water table decreases, you are in scarcity of water. So this is the problem. Then there are few ways how solution can be provided to this problem. Since water is precious and we must stop, so we have to provide here the ingredients. I mean, not ingredients exactly, but we have to provide here the suggestions which can stop the wastage of water. So what is the first suggestion here? That apply rainwater harvesting. So rainwater harvesting is necessary. So if you apply that, what will happen? Don't let rainwater run waste. So first thing, so how can you apply this? Let not rainwater run waste, then preserve it in tanks and ponds. And you can add some more points, whatever you feel are correct. So you can add in here. So this is one way of saving water. Second is make judicious use of water. So usage of water. So how can you do that? Reduce shower time by 2 minutes. Will save at least 2 buckets, and then use mop instead of floor wash, and then reuse filtered water in watering plants and washing vegetables. So these are few points which I felt all of a sudden, and then I have jotted down here. So what you have to do, you have to increase these points. You can also make use of better points which come in your mind. So this is just a sample. You can see this and you can create your own beautiful poster on that. Save this gift for next generation. Save water, save life. So this is the tagline that I've given here to this poster. And lastly, I have added here, issued by National Water Commission, Government of India. So this is the issuing authority. Who is issuing? Since it is about water, so I have added here one nice name, that is National Water Commission. And then since it is coming in the government sector, so I have written here Government of India. It is issued in the name of Government of India. So this is the sample of poster making, which is on the precious, how water is precious and how we can stop water wastage. So I hope you have understood this. Please try to create your own poster on this particular topic. This will prepare you. And if you find any problem, any difficulty, you can comment below in the comment section. And if you've liked this video, please like, share and subscribe and share with more and more people. Thanks.